Hello everyone. This message is for the police officers who came to our home late last night to apprehend three individuals who were on our property attempting to come and take our dog Bella from us. These are three teenagers. They have been identified. Their parents have been notified. I deeply appreciate the help of the police. I don't know how you do your job. It must be extremely difficult. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for showing up and doing a great job. For everybody else, you don't need to worry about me. I am not the real victim here. The animals are. We will not be deterred by people who harass us. We will never stop. The animals are too important. They are suffering, and we will let the public know about what they go through. Thank you to everyone who is helping with this endeavor.
Yes, I do, because every human born into this world only causes more suffering to animals and humans. It's extremely unsustainable since we are already very overpopulated, and since most humans are too egocentric to live a sustainable lifestyle, we are very rapidly destroying the environment. So there isn't much of a future left to enjoy. We're just gonna keep seeing more and more natural disasters, more and more extreme temperatures, which is just gonna force more and more humans and non-humans to suffer and die. And personally, I don't even enjoy being alive because of how much constant suffering there is in this world. Because of how extremely horrible most humans are. So I wouldn't want anyone else to live in this horrible world because I don't want them to suffer. If I could delete all humans from existence by snapping my fingers, I would.
That's creative. Did you come up with that? That's creative. Is that your idea? That's creative. Did you come up with that? That's creative. Did you come up? That's creative.
Because we care very much about animals, and we are very passionate about ending their oppression. So please stop harming animals and go vegan, okay? Why are we screaming?
Are you trans?
No.
Why do you have your pronouns in your bio?
Because transphobic people will attack trans people because they have their pronouns in their bio, so they think that they're trans. So if we were to normalize everybody doing it, they wouldn't be attacked.
Hello. I just want to talk about oppression for a second. There are many groups that claim that they are the most oppressed group. There is one group of individuals who do not say anything, and that is the animals, because they have no spokespeople. They don't have Twitter, they don't have TikTok, they have nobody. The only people they have are animal rights activists, who are a tiny, tiny percentage of all vegans. I will be the voice of animals, as a primary voice for all oppressed. I do, of course, feel for all other oppressed groups, but I will call them out as well. I have called out black people. When they abuse animals, that means eat them, wear them, pay for them as entertainment. I've done the same thing for the LGBTQ community, for feminists, all groups. Nobody's off the hook. Hey everyone, here's the Bella update. You can see that she's super excited to get into the water. I got a stick here, I'm gonna throw it for her. So for those of you who are joining us newly, Bella has been vegan since August 2017. So that's been 3 years. She has had no animal products. She is 100% healthy according to the vet. She eats either Gather brand or Evolution brand of dog food. Where'd she go? There she is. So typically she jumps in and gets the stick, and like any normal dog, she wants to hold onto it for a while. She tries to hide it there, and when she's good and ready, I take it and throw it back in. So if Bella can be vegan, maybe, just maybe, you can too. Of course you can. Happy Vegan Declaration Day.
Hello everyone. I had to come to the police station about some animal rights issues. And while I was here, it occurred to me that, you know, I should tell you guys about how important it is to make the link with everybody, even every police officer you meet or public security person, even your dentist, your doctors, about veganism and how it's connected to them and to the animals. For example, you can remind police officers that it is healthy for their bodies and get them to watch The Game Changers. If you are at your dentist's office, you could suggest What the Health, and also because it's similar. And if you are anywhere at all and they've already seen those things and you want to proceed to the next level, you ask them to watch Earthlings, Dominion Movement, or Cowspiracy. It's always a good time to remind people about the animals. Skinny? What makes you think you're going to be skinny? Do you know how hard I work to keep this weight? I have to constantly struggle not to eat as much as I want to. Watch The Game Changers and see healthy vegan athletes. They're strong! Nobody wants to change evolution. We can't anyway. That's in the past. We are simply pointing out the fact that you can be healthy at any stage of development if you are a vegan. 100% healthy. Just educate yourself, watch The Game Changers, and What the Health. I know, right? So many vegans from 2016. Does anybody have a theory about it? Personally, I think it has something to do with Gary Yourofsky. Maybe at the height of his popularity, I mean, he had such an effect on me. Yes, isn't it great? If I had more likes than comments, I would know I'm doing something wrong. I'm here to shake things up. I am a disruptor. I'm here to make you think about veganism. I don't just want vegan friends. Nope, it's not bad to go vegan. Have you seen any of the documentaries that I keep posting? This can't be explained, all of this, in a TikTok video. Go watch earthlings.com on YouTube right now. Go watch it. Why should I start a fans only? Won't I just be lonely? Not that many people like me. But seriously, what is it? What is a fans only? I have no idea what that means. Hello students, this is nutritional yeast. If you've never seen it before, this is what it looks like inside. Look, it's kind of like cheesy, but it contains no animal product. And this is something that we vegans sprinkle on all kinds of things, salads and inside soups. And I'm making a pasta right now, so I'm just gonna dump a bunch of it in there, and it makes it a little bit cheesy-ish. And if you look at the ingredients, it's just yeast, really. And on the back here, it says B12, 880%. That's a lot of what you would need in a day in your daily requirement. So it's really great for B12, which is something that vegans need to make sure that they get. So what you gonna do? Get nutritional yeast. Put this stuff on everything. It is so good. Nutritional yeast, buy some today.
Hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog. Let's make one with carrots. Real carrots, like so, like that. Use about a cup of coconut aminos or soy sauce. Few tablespoons of A1. Few tablespoons of raw agave. Few cups of water if you measure, but honey, I do it from the spirit. Couple splashes of liquid smoke. And a little bit of ketchup. And because it's my business, a little garlic powder. Then put it in your pot and bring it to a boil. First, chop the top of your carrot off. Then using a skinner, we're gonna skin it. Like so, like that. Then put them in the water and boil for about 10 to 15 minutes. Then after they boil for 10 minutes, cover it up and boil for 10 more minutes. Then take them out. Then add them to your cast iron skillet. And when you flip them, they look like so, like that. Ooh, come on, carrots. Put one of them in a bun. Add your favorite topping. Are you getting into it? Ooh, God, we thank you. See that? That's pecan chili with my little coleslaw.
In case you haven't met her yet, this is Bella. She is our dog. What the heck's going on here? Okay. She's been vegan since August 2017, and she's doing great. She has this kind of like bony thing, this toy thing that was peanut butter flavored. And
don't you choose on that every once in a while? Today she went on 2 really long walks and a swim. And she's sweet. We love her. She sleeps in our bed with us. And that's it. I just wanted you to meet her because I love her so much. I think she's going to have a rest now because she had too much exercise. Bye-bye for now. A few years ago, I took the time to study this author and what she has written about, which is called The Work. Her name is Byron Katie. I suggest you get some of her books or any of her books or just watch her videos on YouTube. 4 questions and a turnaround. The work can be applied to any thought that causes you anger, fear, sadness, or frustration. Any thought that keeps you from living in peace. Here are the questions that you ask yourself. Is it true? So let's say you have a bad thought about somebody, you ask yourself, is it true? Can you absolutely know that it's true? How do you react when you believe that thought? Who would you be without the thought? And then you do these things called turnarounds. And basically, it just gives you a new perspective on things. Byron Katie. Check it out on YouTube. Bye for now. Yes, Vegan Declaration Day is every day. It's the day that you decide that you want to be vegan and you stop buying cruelty. Is it your day today? Write it down. Listen, when I first became vegan, I used to buy my dog just regular food like everybody else does. I didn't really think about it till somebody said to me, "You're not really vegan if you are paying people to kill other animals for your animal." I was in shock. I didn't think that dogs could be vegan. Bella looks like a wolf. I was like, that can't work. And they said, yeah, do some research. And so I did. And so I changed. When you know better, you do better. Chickens, cows, and pigs have a right to their lives as well. You know, imagine if you had a pet chicken or a pet pig and it was so cute. And then someone said, oh no, we have to kill those and feed Bella. Like, no. Dogs can be vegan. You should be vegan. Yeah. Happy Vegan Declaration Day to you. Happy Vegan Declaration Day to you. Whether you've been vegan for a lifetime or just a minute, welcome to the club. We're so glad you're in it. Everybody sing along. Happy Vegan Declaration Day to you. Happy Vegan Declaration Day to you. Everywhere around the world, animals are lining up to thank you for your compassion and for allowing your heart to open up. Excellent. So, wow, what's going to happen tomorrow? What are you going to eat? What are you going to do? Don't freak out. You don't have to throw out all your leather stuff and your wool stuff right away. Just go easy on yourself. It's just the first day. But stick with it. Don't quit. Proud of you. We never punish dogs for barking. We humans have bred these dogs. We basically are in charge of their existence. And so, if they're in our houses and they're barking, it's because they don't really want to be in our houses. They don't want to be stuck in there. They want to be free, but they can't be free because we have all these rules of society. So we have to be extra nice to all the pets that we have. Extra understanding. Okay, they didn't ask to be born and brought into your house. We never, ever hurt animals. They are like children. We treat them with kindness and patience. If your dog's barking, take your dog out for a walk until he or she is exhausted. That's your job. Yep. And be vegan. Are you in that situation right now? Tomorrow for breakfast. Do you have any food in your fridge? If you have cow's milk, You shouldn't be drinking it. You should be drinking a plant-based milk. Lunchtime? Are you going to eat chicken? Are you going to eat a pig? What are you going to eat? Are you in that situation right now where you have no choice? Do not live near a store. There's lentils, beans, tofu, kale, every kind of fruit or vegetable. Your whole mind will explode when you become vegan. There are so many choices and amazing recipes on Bosch.tv. You know, just stop trying to find excuses. Being vegan is healthy. Go to howdoigovegan.com, research, and watch Earthlings, the documentary, Earthlings. No, vegetarians are not trying their best. Well, they are if they don't really know about the dairy industry and the egg industry. But if they know about those industries, about how they take the baby boy chicks when they're born, because they'll never lay eggs, and put them in a blender and crush them alive. If they know that, and they keep on eating eggs, it's not okay. And now you know. If they know about the milk industry, that the babies are taken away from their moms so that we steal the milk, and then we make ice cream with it and cheese, and now you know it. So are you going to go tomorrow and keep eating these things, knowing that you're paying people to do that for you? Vegetarianism is not good enough, not even close. We need a vegan world. And there's a mosquito in here. Good night, everybody. You're bored? How the fuck can you be bored? Do you already know everything about the world? Go watch earthlings.com right now, earthlings.com, and report back to me in the morning. I'm going to sleep. Good night, sir or ma'am, whoever you are.